Add it to your coffee, pour it over your cereal, or just drink a glass of it. Milk is a staple in practically any fridge. Besides essential vitamins and minerals, there might be something else in milk that's not good for you.
A bunch of dairy farms over the years have reported PFAS contamination in their water or their soil, and then subsequently in their cows and then the milk that the cows produce.
PFAS, also known as forever chemicals because they essentially never break down naturally, have been linked to cancer, immunity, and endocrine problems, and infertility.
PFAS have historically been added to consumer products to make them nonstick, waterproof, stain resistant. And then once PFAS are out in the world, they end up in our water supply, in the fertilizer that farms use, and they end up in our food, and they end up in us.
To investigate the potential problem, CR recently conducted a limited test of 50 samples of whole milk purchased from grocery stores in 5 states. The good news, CR found PFOS or PFOA, 2 PFAS that are most often linked to harmful health effects, in only 6 of the 50 samples.
No one should stop drinking milk based on these findings. However, it does show how our federal food safety agencies and manufacturers are not monitoring for PFAS in milk and other foods, and the needs for health protective limits for these harmful chemicals.
But the results also raised some red flags. In response to questions from Consumer Reports, the International Dairy Foods Association said, quote, "Dairy foods and beverages are highly regulated and rely on a verified system to ensure their safety and integrity. If you're concerned about PFAS, you can limit your exposure by avoiding stain and water-resistant clothing and carpets and using cookware that claims to be PTFE-free, such as pans with ceramic coatings." Andrea Flores, KCRA 3 News.
Now, other ways to limit your PFAS exposure: test your drinking water for contaminants. If present, use a water filter certified to remove them.